Hi everyone, it's Tammy from Nutmeg Notebook. Be sure and check out my blog at nutmegnotebook.com. Today I want to show you how to make garlic mashed potatoes in the Instant Pot, which is a pressure cooker. So I hope you all have a pressure cooker already. I actually own three of these and I use them all the time. Sometimes I have all three going at the same time. So for today's recipe, you're going to need 2 pounds of potatoes. These are Yukon Gold potatoes, which are my favorite for mashed potatoes because they kind of have a nice yellow color to them and a little bit of a buttery taste to them. But if you don't have access to Yukon Golds, use what you have. If you have russets or little red potatoes, use those. They'll still make delicious potatoes, mashed potatoes. Also, you're gonna need some garlic. I have 8 cloves here. You can use more or less according to what you like. And then this is just some low sodium vegetable broth. I buy this at Whole Foods. This happens to be the Injun 2 brand because it's the lowest sodium one that I've been able to find. Occasionally, I've been able to find some with no sodium, but that's rare. And I adhere to a low sodium diet. So what we're gonna do is take the lid off of our pressure cooker. I'm going to just add the broth in. My potatoes have been washed and cut up into even sizes, and we're just going to put those right in the pressure cooker along with the garlic. And we're going to mash these so we don't need to mince the garlic or chop it ahead of time. And we'll put the lid on. And if you put it kind of at an angle, it goes on easier. You want to make sure that the steam valve is set to the steam, not the venting, so that it will get to pressure. Then I'm just going to set it by using the manual setting. Click on the manual, go up here to the minus, and I'm going to set the time. I'm going to do 4 minutes. This is all I have to do. It is going to beep one more time, letting me know that it is set. And then we just wait for it to come up to pressure. Once it comes up to high pressure, it will cook for 4 minutes, and then it will start to decrease and release the pressure. So I'll check back with you when it's time to mash. Okay, so hear that beep? That's telling me that the cooking time that I had set it for is over. So now you have 2 options. You can let the pressure come down naturally, or you can release the pressure. And I'm gonna go ahead and release the pressure. So you can do it with your finger, but my husband, Tom, he always says, oh, I don't want you to get a burn. Use something so that you're not touching it. So I just moved the valve to venting like that. And you see the steam is coming out of it. So when I do this, I don't want it to be underneath my cabinets because I don't want that steam coming up and ruining the cabinetry. So it's nice if you do have an island to be able to put the pressure cooker on the island. If you do have to put it underneath your cabinets, just pull it out and turn it so that the venting will not go up into your cabinet. So as the pressure is releasing, I'll just tell you what we're gonna add in for the mashed potatoes. So I have 1/2 cup of unsweetened almond milk, and I like to warm it up in the microwave to take the chill off of it so that it doesn't cool down my mashed potatoes. And then I have Table Tasty, which is a salt-free seasoning. It's a salt substitute, and I order this online, and it's really tasty. And a little bit of freshly ground black pepper, a little bit of cayenne pepper, just a little bit, and some dried chives, because I don't have fresh today. So if you have fresh, of course, fresh would be better, but I don't have any, so we'll just have to go with that. Okay, the little valve on here just dropped. It just made a little click, and that lets me know that the pressure is all released and that it's safe to open the lid. And just so you know, the lid will not open if the pressure isn't down. So it's pretty foolproof. You can't get hurt. So we just want to turn it and lift the lid off. Now, if you're going to be serving, the lid does fit in the little hole here. So if you're going to be serving right out of the Instant Pot, this is kind of cool. It gets it up off the serving table, so it's not in your way. But I'm going to take it off because I'm actually going to be mashing the potatoes. So the great thing about cooking them in the Instant Pot is that you can mash them right in the pot. And so I'm just going to give them a little bit of a mash. And I have that vegetable broth is in there. I'm going to grab a little hot pad to hold this. Try to keep it from making so much noise. And so I might not need to use the full half cup of almond milk. We'll just see how things look as I'm mashing. Okay, they're starting to get nice and mashed. I want to make sure that I get to those. Oh, I've got to shut my microwave off. It's beeping at me. There we go. Sorry about that. It's real life, real kitchen. I'm going to add some of the almond milk. Mash it. And so, you know, if you like your mashed potatoes thicker, use less. If you like them runnier, use more. Also, I left the skins on my potatoes because the skins of Yukon Golds are really thin, and I actually like that extra fiber in my mashed potatoes, but some people don't like that. So peel them if you want to, but you know, it saves me a step. Okay, so now I'm going to add a little bit of freshly ground pepper. I'm gonna add about a tablespoon of the Table Tasty salt substitute because we really like it. And a sprinkling of chives, maybe about a tablespoon. And then just a dash of the cayenne pepper, because I just like that little bit of kick that it gives them. Okay, these are looking really good. I am going to add just a little more of my almond milk and I'm actually going to use some of these today to stuff some large portobello mushrooms that I'm going to then heat up in my Breville Smart Oven air fryer, and that'll be really delicious. So I'll make another video and show you guys how to do that. Okay, I'm gonna call this good. They smell amazing, you guys. They look pretty darn good too. Yum. So here, let's put them out in this bowl. So I need to try this with some sweet potatoes and see how that would be. Doesn't that sound good? Some garlic mashed sweet potatoes. Okay, there you have it. Garlic mashed potatoes made in the Instant Pot. Super easy, and this is great for the holidays, because you can do a lot of potatoes in here. I easily could double that. And I have an 8-quart Instant Pot pressure cooker that you can do a huge batch of potatoes in. And you can set it to warm, put the lid on it, and put it on your buffet table, and it'll keep the potatoes hot until you're ready to serve them. All right, guys, that's it for today. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.